For the first time, scientists have discovered evidence of phosphorus in an ocean not on Earth. A new study in the Journal of Nature says the life-sustaining element was found inside salty ice grains shot into space by one of Saturn's moons. Not only is phosphorus vital to all life on Earth, but its presence supports the idea that there could be an ocean capable of sustaining life beneath that moon's icy surface. The co-author of the study says, quote, "The next step is clear. We need to go back to see if the habitable ocean is actually inhabited." And joining us now is a man who needs no introduction, Bill Nye, the science guy. Bill, what do you make of all this? The possibilities are kind of extraordinary here. What do you think?
Well, so if you have an ocean, a salty ocean for a few billion years, maybe there's something alive. And so, so far, using the data collected by the Cassini spacecraft, everybody was pretty sure there's water, hydrogen and oxygen, sulfur, but finding phosphorus, atomic number 15, is significant because, you know what we say in magic, they say it's all done with mirrors. You know what we say in biochemistry? It's all done with molecules. So when it comes to us, our DNA is held up. The edge of our DNA is phosphorus. And so phosphorus and sugar make the so-called backbone or the railings of the staircase of DNA. And then you've probably heard of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. That's the battery. That's the energizer of our cells. And so having phosphorus is very important to us and all the other living things that we know of, which are all on Earth. But I'll tell you, sir, if we were to find evidence of life on another world,
right,
it would change this world.
How so?
Everybody would feel differently about being a living thing.
Yeah, expand on that, because I think you're absolutely right about that. I think the entire planet, our planet, would just be mesmerized if there were some images or, you know, if we were to find some kind of sign of life on this moon.
Some Enceladusians of some sort.
Yeah.
You know, there's a layer of ice, a shell of ice, and under that is this ocean. And it's kept liquid by the gravity of, by the mutual gravity of Enceladus and Saturn, squeezing it, and it keeps it warm enough to be liquid all these billions of years. And you cannot help but wonder these two questions we all ask. Where did we come from? How did life get started? Whose idea was this? I know people are very sure of some things, but fundamentally, scientifically, we don't know how life started. And then you wonder, if it started here, could it start somewhere else? Are we alone? And then the other deep question is, we have DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. Oh, by the way, phosphorus is what makes it acidic. It's very important to its function. So we have DNA. Does another form of life on another world have DNA? Does DNA always get involved? Is it always part of the equation? And then furthermore, did life start somewhere else and end up here because things fall toward the sun after their impacts out there?
Right.
Are we descendants of Enceladusians? That's quite a hypothesis, but we investigated, everybody, for a tiny fraction of the federal budget. A tiny fraction of space agency budgets around the world go to this kind of investigation, and it leads to these extraordinary discoveries. Back to you.
Well, and I mean, if this were to be, you know, I mean, if we were to find some more evidence of this, we would have to go. And how would we go and further confirm what may be taking place there? Do we even have anything figured out how to get to Mars? Besides sending rovers and that sort of thing, how would we figure this out?
When you start getting out, when you start getting out as far as Jupiter or Saturn, getting people out there becomes fantastically complicated. I'm not saying it's impossible, but it just takes a huge investment. But 2027, we're planning to launch the Dragonfly mission to another one of Saturn's moons, Titan, which is equally intriguing. This phosphorus thing is just this week. But it just shows you also the tremendous value of these missions. Cassini flew, it's 2017, and it launched 12 years before that. And these data are still being analyzed. They're still thinking deep thoughts about what the instruments can tell us about these other worlds. And so everybody, we're not jumping on a rocket to go to Saturn, but we are going to send another spacecraft there. And this is the extraordinary dragonfly, Octocopter. It's going to fly around in the Titanic atmosphere. It's going to be amazing. Yeah. And once again, as I say all the time, it's just the investment is just very, very small. And if you are watching in the U.S., you're a U.S. citizen or what have you, NASA is the best brand the United States has. People everywhere respect NASA. And furthermore, that's another mission that engage, just like Cassini, engages space agencies and scientists, engineers, and taxpayers, voters around the world.
Yeah.
Well, thank you.
Well, you're absolutely right, Bill. You've given us a lot to think about. We'll be dreaming about this moon tonight, perhaps, and wondering what lies out there.
Yes. Phosphorus.
Science Phosphorus. Fiction quickly becoming science fact. Bill Nye, the science guy. Thanks so much. Great to talk to you. Appreciate
absolutely.
It.
Thank you, sir. Carry on.
All right.